So breakfast is coffee, eggnog with heavy cream and stevia drops. It is delicious. I'm also watching. No, where'd it go?
What's Miracle on 34th Street thing? What's that? I've never seen that movie. Is that terrible?
Look who's on my phone. So I'm doing the live stream, watching Lauren's live stream, and talking to Erin, Keto Hot Mess Express in the corner. And that's it. That is my morning. This needs a little bit more sweetness because it is heavy on the nog, not so much on the sweet. So I also had a slice of Swiss cheese and buffalo turkey, chicken, buffalo chicken. But I'm gonna charge my phone battery before I go out, and then I'm taking you guys shopping with me again because I need a shirt. So I am having a hair day. I'm having a very good hair day. It started out as me putting it in a high pony. Holy sun. I put it in a high pony and then curled it, and then I took the curls out, and now it looks like this, and I'm digging it. Seatbelt's already on. What is going on? I am chilling on my day off, jamming to some NSYNC Christmas. I am a 90s child through and through. You do not get much more 90s than this. So good morning, almost good afternoon. It is a little bit after 11. I am heading to Old Navy over in Mobile because I have to find a shirt to wear to his holiday party, which is next Friday. Speaking of next Friday, I also get to go get my blood work done for work, so that's fun. But I'm gonna go over to the Mobile Inn, or to the Mobile in Old Navy, the Old Navy in Mobile, because I can also then go to Home Goods and there is a Dollar Tree there and all the things. So I do that, and yeah, my morning has been pretty uneventful. I woke up, texted the repair guy, and was like, hey, just confirming, still coming at 10 a.m. from my oven. He asked me to call him, and he's like, yeah, listen, so somebody wanted me to come and move their trailer at 9 a.m. I'm like, uh-huh. Well, what does your day look like? I'm busy all day. I made plans. I did. I made a day date with myself. I'm going out, and I'm doing all the things. And he goes, well, and I'm like, yeah, but I get it, but we made an appointment a week ago for 10 a.m. for you to come and fix my oven. I said, it's literally gonna take you 5 minutes. You have to take out the old component and put the new one in. I would do it, but I don't mess with that stuff. Like, I am not a fixer person. I appoint, I supervise. So he goes, well, can you do it between like 8:30 and 9? And at this point it was like 8 a.m. and I'm like, that's fine. So I get up, I get dressed, and like 8:30 rolls around. I'm like, all right, I'll actually like prepare myself for the day. So I wind up like starting to do my makeup and everything, and I watch Lauren's live, which thank you so much, Lauren, for doing that live, because I gained almost 50 subscribers from that live. So girl, thanks. And also thanks for saying that I'm killing it and being 35. Seriously though, contour, it's a lifesaver. So I was watching her vlog, and then he messaged me, and it was like 9 o'clock. He goes, oh, I'm running late, I'll be there about 9:45. And I'm like, all right, like I don't really have a choice, like I'm at your mercy. So the whole entire thing of him getting me all pissy because he was trying to screw me over for a job that he would make more at was a moot point, because he wound up getting to my house at like 10 of 10. And I'm like, you could have just not texted me and just shown up at 10 of 10. Like, I am the type of person that if you're gonna be there at 10, I fully expect you to be there between quarter of and like 5 of. So, because I'm like a crazy punctual person. I have anxiety attacks if I run late. Like, even, like, say I was going to a friend's house and I'd be like, I'll be there between 11:45 and 12. I get there at like 11:52. Like, I'm literally between the time frame. But that was my morning with that. So I watched Lauren's live. I watched the whole thing. I was in there the whole time. Did my hair, did my makeup, which really my makeup is like non-existent lately because a girl don't have time. And then I made some coffee, which I drank like half of because I wasn't feeling it. And then I'm on my way to Old Navy now because I need to find the shirt. So that's been my morning. Very, very uneventful. You guys didn't see my dinner last night. I will put pictures in. We wound up going to a little bar called Beef O'Brady's. And have you ever gone and like not known what you want to order? So you just like randomly pick something and then as soon as you get it, you're like, this is everything. This is exactly what I needed in my life. That was this. I got fajitas, no tortillas. And like, I was gonna say screw it and get the tortillas, but then I was like, I can't because come on, like I can't. I got steak and shrimp. It had green peppers and onions, cause fajitas. And then I put a little bit of cheese on, but not much cause fajitas don't need cheese, but tacos do. And I got, it came with sour cream and salsa. So I had some of that. I will put in before and after pictures in the video as well. But I checked my GKI yesterday and I wasn't even in ketosis. I was at like a 10 point something. So I wasn't far off. But something I am eating slash drinking is causing me to not produce ketones or my sugar to be a little bit higher. My sugar was only 92. By sugar, I mean glucose, sorry. But something is going on. And the only thing that has truly changed in my diet is I've been using Swerve sweetener instead of Pure. And I've been eating a little bit more with the maltitol candies and the like squeezy water enhancers. So I'm gonna try to limit myself on the Swerve, which should not be an issue. It should be fine because it's stevia or erythritol. It's one of those two. I never remember what's what. But the only thing I can think of is probably the maltitol candies is causing my blood sugar to rise. But when I checked it, I hadn't had any. So I don't know if it's like a residual effect, if it's happening, you know, almost 14, 18 hours later. You know, this was after a fast. I fasted for 18 hours yesterday. My version of fasting. So coffee, a bang, and water enhancer. So it has to be something, it has to be one of the sweeteners. So I'm trying to cut back. This morning I made my coffee with the stevia liquid sweet drop things. And I had that piece of cheese and a piece of buffalo chicken meat. That was it. I will probably grab something while I'm out. What? I don't know. Depends on how hungry I am and where I am. What sucks is there's a Panda Express exactly where I'm going. And I could go for some Panda Express and some good shit. But I'm not going to. Because willpower, right? Willpower. Ugh. So, thank you again for all of the new subscribers. I appreciate it so much. I am desperately trying to grow this channel and like supplement my income a little bit with it. Like, I really would like to be able to make some sort of bill be paid by YouTube, whether it's my electric bill or preferably my car payment, because my car payment is astronomical for my piece of crap car. For those of you who don't know, I drive a Nissan Versa. And in the 5 years that I've had it, I have had to replace the tires multiple times because they keep dying. Like the tread on them is ridiculous, which is partially my fault. I could just get better tires. I have had to get the exhaust worked on twice. The muffler fell off at one point. I have a tapping that I've had since I got the car that I was told that's just the Versa. Rust issues, engine issues. The car only has almost 14,000 miles on it. It's 113,788 miles. It's a 7-year-old car. 8, really, because 2011s came out in 2010. So I don't think that's bad. A lot of it was put on because he was using my car for a while going back and forth to work. I lent it to my sister, which she needed it to go back and forth to work. And then when I was working in Foley, it was a lot of driving. It was an hour drive each way. And now I'm putting mileage on it going into Gulf Breeze and stuff. But It's just not a great car, and I still have a year to pay it off. Because my credit was awful, it's still not great, but since it was so awful, I wound up, I'm paying like $30,000 for this car, and I have manual windows and locks, so there's that. Now that I have literally rambled on about nothing, I'm gonna let you guys go. I'm gonna take you shopping with me, and you're gonna help me pick out clothes. And by you're gonna help me, it means that I'm going to see what I look like on camera and choose from that way, because by the time you guys see this, I will have bought a shirt, hopefully. I'm gonna jam out to some Christmas music.
All right, we are going into Old Navy. I am doing this with my camera, which is super weird for me, but we're gonna go with it. Thank you. This is the shirt I actually have on, just in stripies. I kind of love this. Do they have it in an extra large just in case? It isn't all the way down there. We'll try to adjust the extra extra. These are 40 off. But 40 off of $36.99. We'll try that one too. Been a while since I've had a good cable knit sweater. Alright, so we got two things so far. We've been in the store for 5 minutes. This gives me 90s vibes. I wore a lot of crushed velvet in the late 90s. Nobody's even looking at me, which is hysterical. Oh my god, look at the Buffalo Check onesie. They're super cute. Ooh. This is super cute. I love this. Oh, it's a dress. No. These are those sweaters. They don't have a ton of stuff. And that makes me sad. Classic plaid. All right, let's go try this stuff on. But this is atrocious. Like, I grabbed it on my way to the dressing room. I look like a tablecloth. So I have seen worse things. This will be obviously worn with jeans, but I don't think I'm feeling the turtleneck, and I'm afraid it would be too warm to wear at Dave & Buster's. Okay, so this is definitely a contender. So it's just blue with gold polka dots. I just don't know what shoes I would wear with it. I don't have anything that would really go with it. Maybe Converse, but that's about it. This one's definitely a contender. This one just beat out that. I love this. And it's very me. Not so much with the leggings. This is super cute. I like this.
Okay, so I like this.
but I don't think I like it enough to buy it. It's a little short. And a little tight.
Is it extra?
Yeah, it's this one. I could probably do an extra, extra large, but that one is lighter. Like, I think it would bode well better for Dave and Buster's.
Here it goes. That wins. My battery's gonna die. Son of a bitch.
All right, so now I'm in Home Goods. This is way more crowded than Old Navy was. Like the balls. It's super cute. Love. So they had some cute stuff at Home Goods, but nothing that really struck my fancy, especially as far as like Radon stuff. I could go into Ross, but I don't think they carry as much as Home Goods or TJ Maxx. So we're not gonna do that. And now I get to figure out what I want for lunch. I'm finally eating. I actually just wound up coming home for lunch, and it's a good thing I did because otherwise it would have been all of the things. Cheese, buffalo chicken, chipotle mayo, buffalo pickles. Gonna put it in my face. Hey guys, it's just about 4 o'clock. I'm on my way to the store. I was gonna place an Instacart order, but it was just way too much and I am not in the mood. I feel like garbage. Something, I don't know if I ate something or I'm just exhausted, but all of a sudden I got like super nauseated. And all I want to do is go to sleep. Legit, all I want to do. So I'm running to Publix in my slippers. They're UGG slippers, so don't think I'm going to Walmart. I'm kidding. I go out in my regular slippers too. I don't care. They have a hard bottom, so they're more like a shoe. I have to get something to drink for myself. And because I want something other than water and the squeezy enhancer things. And I want to have cheese brats for dinner, so I gotta get some of them. But I tested my ketones, and I did my GKI before I left the house, and my sugar tested at 107, and my ketones were 0.5. So I think I have discovered the culprit. I thought originally it was the swerve, but then I haven't had it for 2 days, so it's not the swerve. I'm not eating anything with hidden carbs. Except Russell Stover's. So I had 2 peppermint patties and that's fun. No idea where that's from. That is all that I have had that is like wonky. So we're done with those. We're done with the maltitol. I wonder if that's what upset my stomach. It very well could be. But it's aggravating because they didn't bother me for the longest time and they didn't kick me out of ketosis for the longest time. So my plan is I really do want to start. I know I keep saying this. I want to start intermittent fasting. And then I say when I do intermittent fasting, I wind up like breaking my fast and eating everything. And say, seriously, why am I bleeding? But I think what I'm going to try to do is hold off that hunger with water.
like regular water, maybe have some true lemon in there instead of the water enhancers. And I want to start that tonight. So I don't want to eat between, what is it, 8 and 12, I think, is the 16-8 fast. So why are we all in the right-hand lane? I don't understand. There's two lanes. Do you have to be in the right-hand lane? Because I do. I hate driving at this time of the day. I really don't want to drive any time after like 3 o'clock. Seriously, my hair is on point today. Brought back my Pandora bracelet. I haven't been wearing it for a while. It was too tight and it was just getting to be too much, but it fits a little bit better now. So that's my afternoon story. You guys saw my lunch, and then I watched Merry Christmas on Netflix. I fell asleep in the recliner for a little bit. Cleaned the bathroom, straightened up. I'm running the robo back now. I was supposed to wrap presents. I just don't have it in me. I just don't. It's such a pain in the ass with where I have to wrap. Luckily this year we don't have carpet, so if I have to do it on the floor I can, but I'm so old that I don't sit well on the floor. This has been 3 minutes and 50 seconds of me bitching. Aren't you glad you subscribed to me? Seriously, I'm usually very upbeat. I really don't feel well. Like, my stomach really hurts. I want to vomit. And I'm not going to stop strictly based on the fact that you don't think you should stop. Oh, and I have road rage. All right, I'm going into Publix. I'm going to get some stuff. No mothball stuff because... All right, that should be my thumbnails. Just me going, hmm. All right, guys. Thanks for listening to me, bitch. Today's a long vlog. I might put this into 2 days. My hair, though. So dinner is 2 cheese, bratwurst, and some shrewd food. Brick oven pizza, protein crisps with some jalapeno aioli. And NCIS. Alright, so dessert is hot chocolate. He has some Swiss Miss, and I have keto hot chocolate. So it's a cup of almond milk, some heavy whipping cream, 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, some Swerve, and then... I whisked that all together. I added some mint one-on-one to make it a peppermint hot chocolate, because basic. And then I have 2 servings of regular Ready Whip on top, and I may have shoved like 7 mini marshmallows in my mouth. Don't judge me. This is it, and then I am doing the intermittent fasting, so good night.